Ano po ba ang mga methods of alterations, or what are the methods of alterations? Ano po ba ang mga methods of alterations, or what are the methods of alterations? Okay, these are the methods of alterations of document. Una, alteration may be done through erasure, either mechanical or chemical. Okay, so erasures can be done mechanically, no, or with the application of some chemicals just to remove, no, just to erase words or phrases or sentences in a particular document. Cancellation, it may be done through striking out or scratching out words. In some other cases, cancellation is done by wiping out a particular words, okay, through some liquid. Meron tayong tinatawag na liquid erasers, diba? Okay, or scraping, no, words, phrases or sentences in a particular document. Next method is substitution. Substitution meaning there is what we call removal, no? Removal of one page, or usually, no, substitution is done by inserting, removing first and then inserting new pages, okay, or page in a particular document. Lalo na yung mga agreements that contain several number of pages, okay? There are some instances na mayroon lamang pong isang sentence na gustong baguhin yung isang party, for example, no? Tapos na execute na po, na may mga signatories na po, may mga signatures na po yung isang document, tapos nung ni-review ng isang tao, ng isang party involved, may nakita po siyang hindi po favorable o gusto niya pong baguhin. Kaya nga, what he did is, he edited and then printed the page that he wanted to change. Okay? That is substitution. So yung bagong printan niya, in-insert niya doon sa file. Okay? Doon sa printed na documents na mayroon na pong signature. So kadalasan pag mayroong mga agreements, kaya nga ni-require po tayo or parang practice na po natin na if may mga agreements, no, may mga contract, for example, lahat po ng pages dapat po may mga signatures to prevent insertion, no, substitution of some of the pages. Kasi kung that the other person may intend to change or may intend to substitute or to extract, to remove one page, so kailangan niya pong magpaalam, kailangan niya po ng signature to the parties involved. Kaya kung ang isang contract ay doon lamang po sa last page mayroong signature, delikado po yung tinatawag natin substitution of pages, no, addition of contents of the document. Okay, mayroon tayong tinatawag na insertion or interlineation, no, para kasama na po to sa substitution. Okay, if the document can be edited, okay, meron tayong mga tinatawag na insertion, no, between lines or between words or between paragraphs, no, insertion or interlineation, addition between lines. Okay, meron tayong addition, a matter of adding, no, putting additional words or sentences after the original preparation of the document. Yun po yung na-discuss natin, no. When you substitute page, when you change, when you add pages, of course you need to edit, no? Hindi mo naman siguro palitan yung isang page if wala kang dinagdag. Okay? Wala kang binago sa isang document. Wala kang binagong words, wala kang binagong figures, or wala kang binagong the way sentences are constructed in that particular document ay malamang may binago ka talaga, no? When you want to insert page or words of that particular document. Okay? In some instances, meron din tayong tinatawag na superimposition. Ano po ba ang superimposition? In this case, ang ating pong individual or ang tao po ay meron siyang ginawang overwriting, no? Hindi niya in-erase, no? Hindi siya nag-erase, hindi siya nag-remove. What he did is he just simply overwrites the original document. Kung baga, if yung ano natin, yung words natin, no, hindi, wala siyang binago, kung hindi, his alteration is done by what? By adding writings on top of the words or sentences. Okay? Next, obliteration. Ito ay tinatawag na masking, no, or smearing over writing with black or opaque materials. So para bang the original, no, content of the particular document will be erased totally by putting some ink, no, usually black. So the original content, the original text of that particular document will not be visible, no? Masking or smearing over writing, no? The original writing will not be visible due to the some ink or any opaque materials that will make the writings invisible. Okay, those are the methods of alteration. Okay, so when we go to a computer, no? Computer editing, no? Iba po ang usapan, no? Meron tayong tinatawag na copy paste, di ba? Meron tayong tinatawag na you will just, no, delete some words and then put other words that you want to be inserted in the particular document. Okay? Obliteration and restoration. Okay, dapat po ano, hindi po dapat tayo mag-confuse, no, with regards sa dalawang terms na ito. Okay? Kapag sinasabi nating obliteration, no, na-mention ko kanina kung ano ibig sabihin ng obliteration. Restoration is the opposite. Okay? So ito yung obliteration. According to Cate and Paraso 2016, no, obliteration is the blacking out or smearing over the writing to make the original invisible. Yun ang sinabi ko kanina. Yung original writing po, no? When we encounter the word obliteration, ang isipin po natin ay smearing over writing. Ano po ang epekto? Yung original po na writing, yung original na printed, no, word or sentences, due to the smear, no, due to the blots, okay, the original writings will not be visible. Okay, will not be visible. Hindi mo makikita or hindi mo na mabasa, no? The original writings are illegible. Okay? Restoration, the opposite of obliteration. Kapag meron tayong tinatawag na obliteration, meron tayong restoration. Now, the process of the development of erased writing or bringing out again. Now, meron pong mga photographic, no, methods with the use of filters that will make, no, to bring out the original text, no. Take note except when the document is covered with black, no. If that is totally smeared, no, totally po na smeared po yung ating document, no. Kumbaga ang possibility po in the restoration of that particular original writing will be difficult. Okay? So, unlike if ang ginagamit po ay meron tayong mga white, no? Mga wipe out yung ating mga liquid erasers, ganun. Kadalasan po ay ma-restore pa po yung ating mga writings. But if that particular document ang ibinuhos po na ink ay totally, no, ang ipinahid po na ink ay totally black. Tapos ang ginamit po sa printing, ang ginamit po sa pagsusulat ay black ink, no? Restoration of the original content, restoration of the original text of that particular document will be difficult. Okay?